The defense had presented the exhibits to him and consequently questioned him on them. One of the exhibits, which was dated May 22, 2012, contained a petition written by a group, the Kwara Freedom Network, asking the EFCC to investigate the Kwara State Universal Basic Education Board. The witness had earlier told the Tribune that the petition by the group propelled the EFCC investigation. Another exhibit dated May 7, 2011, was addressed to the chairman of the EFCC, asking the anti-graft agency to investigate the Kwara State government on borrowings for projects described as funny. The last petition dated June 7, 2012, was about mismanagement of local government revenue in Kwara State between 2003 and 2011. The witness told the Tribune that he did not interrogate the Accountant General of Kwara State, and neither did he invite any official of the Kwara State government in the course of investigation. The prosecution witness added that the investigation of the defendant was based on intelligence report obtained by the former chairman of the EFCC, Ibrahim Lamode, and not the three petitions tendered as exhibits. He, however, stated that his team was directed to investigate the intelligence reports alone.
Day to day, we'll do our best. So far, we have done very well, and we really thank God again.
More so when they have all the documentation they are requesting for. So why asking for an adjournment?
Further hearing continues on Wednesday. Wumi Obaburi, AIT News, Abuja.